From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Under the recently proposed American Jobs Act, Maine could receive millions of dollars toward renovating community colleges. At Southern Maine Community College today, a forum examined 26,000 new high-wage and growth jobs that are expected to be created in Maine over 10 years. A report identified some significant skills gaps and the need for jobs in several areas. Those at the forum say if the gap is not addressed, thousands of those jobs could go unfilled. They say community colleges can help fill those gaps.
I'd say we have both supply and we have demand, but they are not matching. And we need to look at the specific occupations, the specific requirements, the specific jobs, and the only way we do that is to talk to the employers themselves.
I know there's a lot of demand for IT. That's part of the reason I really got into it, because I always had an interest, and I was like, well, big job field, lots of people looking for, you know, recent graduates that know what they're doing and are on the cutting edge of technologies.
Those at the forum say that if Maine is able to fill the need for these jobs, the economic ripple effect would create more than $340 million in new economic activity across the state. Education Commissioner Stephen Bowen says Maine's been selected to help lead a national effort to develop more rigorous science standards. Bowen says Maine will have a key role in defining the science content and concepts that students will need to master in the future. Maine will also receive technical assistance in sharing the standards with educators statewide. The standards are expected to be completed by the end of 2012.
And it means all of the states will have a common set of science standards. Our educators will have access to, and our kids will have access to educational materials developed nationally, because all the standards will be the same. And just what it's going to, what the kind of resources it's going to make available, both for our educators and their training and support, and for our kids, is just going to be something we've never seen before.
The commissioner says the other states to lead in the development of the next generation science standards will be announced next week. Bowen made today's announcement at the University of Maine in front of about 80 elementary, middle, and high school teachers, as well as university science educators and principals. Portland's East End Community School says it's getting a nearly $3 million federal grant to offer up more learning opportunities for students. East End plans to extend the school day by a half an hour and buy new technology equipment for classrooms. The school also plans to create a new program called Rise and Shine, which will focus on longer blocks of time for literacy and math instruction. It can host some of the biggest cruise ships in the world, and now the new pier is officially open at the Portland Ocean Gateway. Pier 2, formerly known as the Mega Berth, is nearly 1,200 feet long. This doubles the city's berthing capacity for cruise ships and other large commercial vessels. The Mega Berth cost about $6 million to build. The project is funded by a transportation bond, and a grand opening reception is scheduled for later this month. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.